I found out that actually menstrual blood passes through the cervix area. The menstrual blood actually carry a lot of uterus cells and also the cervical cells and also some vagina secretions and also some cells slut off from the vagina. They are very good sources of being a diagnosis markers of diseases. So from there, I started to work on menstrual blood, try to find out that what we can take from the menstrual blood for diagnosis of different kinds of female diseases. I'm Dr. Pui-Wah Choi. I'm a female scientist that focuses on research on female diseases. I grew up in Hong Kong and I study bachelor here at CUHK Biochemistry Department. So during my undergraduate study, when I was year two, I attended a program held by CUHK and they sent me and sponsored me to do some research at Harvard Medical School, the OBGYN department. At that time, I met a professor from Harvard Medical School. He specialized in ovarian cancer research. He taught me about how to discover biomarkers for diagnosing ovarian cancer. He also taught me how to work on three-dimensional model to reveal the mechanisms underlying the ovarian cancer pathogenesis. My passion for science actually ignited from there. So after I completed my postdoc study at Harvard Medical School, I returned to Hong Kong. So at that time, I was thinking to establish a biotech company in Hong Kong because I think Asia, we could also do something great in biotech industry. And at that time, I met two women. So because of these two women, I started to try to think about how to diagnose female diseases non-invasively. I found out that actually, menstrual blood passes through the cervix area. The menstrual blood actually carry a lot of uterus cells and also the cervical cells and also some vagina secretions and also some cells slut off from the vagina. And these all kind of cells, they are very good sources of being a diagnosis markers of diseases. So from there, I started to work on menstrual blood, try to find out that what we can take from the menstrual blood for diagnosis of different kinds of female diseases. So this is our lab bench, and this is the pads that we work on. This box set is the clinical study box set. So inside the boxes, there is a special sanitary pad which collect the menstruation blood, and we will elute the biomarkers from the menstruation blood for the detection of HPV and cervical cancer. And these are my colleagues. They are also female scientists. They help with the development of the panty liners and also the HPV detection packs and the cervical cancer detection packs. I currently working with my team on a HPV detection project. So we invented a pad, a sanitary pad, for the detection of HPV in the menstruation blood. We found that the HPV screening rate in Hong Kong is super low. It's only 30%, and 70% of women, they are not screened. The problem is there's not many women are willing to take the pap smear. So in some countries, even the pap smear are free. Only like 30% of women are willing to take it. They think it's invasive and it's uncomfortable. This is why we try to find a method that is convenient, that is not invasive, and women feel comfortable to use that. I grew up in a quite traditional family. Parents, they usually teach their girls to play safe. But being an entrepreneur or being a scientist, you have to take risk, because you are doing something great and doing something totally new. So the first thing is you have to be brave. And why you have to be brave? Because the female technology product really needs you. So across the group, there's not a lot of female, we call femtech. So I'm a woman and I understand sanitary pad very well. And I know that for sanitary pack, we rank safety the first. But when I was talking to some like male founders from other companies, they were asked me to like insert some electronics or Wi-Fi receptors or like some reagents or chemicals or some glass fluidic things into the sanitary pad, then I rejected all of them. This is why I say that female or woman actually are the best candidates to develop the femtech related technology. So we really need more women to join us to become a female leader, become a female entrepreneurs, female scientists, in order to create more tools for the women to achieve a better lives. So please be brave and try everything. You could achieve much more than you think.